Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure.
I'm a Muslim, I came from the streets to Islam, the ghetto. Now when you see your brother, give a palm, embrace with a hug and greet me with salam. Salamu alaikum.
It's very important to understand who Sheikh Zakariya rahimahullah ta'ala was. So there is no doubt that Sheikh Muhammad Zakariya was amongst the most distinguished hadith scholars of India and a great contributor in the service of the Sunnah. He was given the honorary title of Sheikh al-Hadith or great scholar of hadith by his great teacher Sheikh Khalil Ahmad Saharanpuri rahimahullah ta'ala, who recognized his deep insight, his clear-sightedness and extensive knowledge of hadith and related sciences. Sheikh Zakariya rahimahullah ta'ala was born in the village of Kandala in Uttar Pradesh, India on February the 12th, 1898 CE. His full name was Muhammad Zakariya ibn Muhammad Yahya ibn Muhammad Ismail, and his lineage continues all the way back to Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala. The great scholar Imam Sheikh Abu al-Hasan Nadwi rahimahullahu ta'ala, he writes about Sheikh Zakariya that Sheikh Zakariya was born into a household which was rooted in knowledge and passion for Islam. His immediate family and his predecessors were distinguished by firm resolve, perseverance, steadfastness and adherence to religion. His family included many notable scholars, and his grandmother, the grandmother of Sheikh Zakariya rahmatullah alayhi, memorized the entire Quran while nursing her son, Sheikh Zakariya's father. His father Muhammad Yahya was among the great scholars of India in both related and logical sciences. And his main teacher was Sheikh Rashid Ahmad Gangohi rahimahullah ta'ala, who was one of the founders of Darul Ulum Deoband. And under Sheikh Rashid Ahmad Gangohi, Mulna Zakariya, Mulna Muhammad Yahya, the father of Mulna Zakariya, he studied Sahih al-Bukhari, Jamiat Tirmizi, Ibn Majah and other books from the six authentic books of hadith which are regarded as known as Siyah Sitta. Sheikh Yahya, after studying under Sheikh Rashid Ahmad Gangohi, he went on to teach at Madrasa Mazahirul Ulum in the district of Saharanpur. But whilst he was teaching, during his time as a teacher, he did not accept any payment for his services. He instead made his living through his own book publishing business. Sheikh Zakariya rahimahullah ta'ala, at an early age, he memorized the Quran with his father and also studied books in Persian and the introductory Arabic books with his uncle Sheikh Muhammad Ilyas rahimahullah ta'ala, who was the founder of Tablighi Jamaat. He stayed with his father in the company of Sheikh Gangohi until he was 8. And when Sheikh Gangohi passed away, Mulna Abu al-Hasan Nadwi writes that he was brought up, Sheikh Zakariya was brought up in the best of environments in his era, the most adhering to the conduct and the sunnah and the furthest from the corruption that had begun to spread in the world. At the age of 12, Sheikh Zakariya traveled with his father to Mazahirul Ulum, and Sheikh Muhammad bin Yahya bathed and performed 2 rakats of prayer and began teaching Mishkatul Masabih, the book of hadith. He then made a lengthy prayer, made a dua for himself and his son. From that day on, hadith became the main focus and goal of Sheikh Zakariya's life. There under his father, he advanced his study of Arabic, tackling many classical texts on Arabic grammar, literature and also logic. But by the time he was 17, hadith became the main focus of his life. He studied 5 of the 6 authentic books of hadith with his father. And then he studied Sahih Bukhari and Sunan al-Tirmizi for a second time with the Honorable Sheikh Khalil Ahmad Saharanpuri rahimahullah ta'ala. And out of his immense respect for hadith, Sheikh Zakariya was extremely particular about always studying the hadith narrations with wuzu. When Sheikh Zakariya was just 19, his father passed away. And this event was extremely traumatic for Sheikh Zakariya, as he lost not just a father, but also a teacher and a mentor. His deep sorrow remained with him for the rest of his life. He had many teachers. Sheikh Zakariya was blessed to live and learn in an era considered by men to be one of the great achievements in Islamic knowledge by scholars in the Indian subcontinent. He studied with a few but select teachers who reached the highest levels of learning, research and authorship and piety. One of his most influential teachers was his own father, Sheikh Muhammad Yahya. Sheikh Zakaria memorized the Quran at the age of 7. At the age of 7, Sheikh Zakaria memorized the Quran. And then according to his father's instruction, he would recite the whole Quran each morning. Each morning, reciting the whole Quran, Allahu Akbar. After studying and graduating from Saharanpur, Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala was assigned to teach 3 sections of Sahih Bukhari upon the insistence of his teacher Sheikh Khalil Ahmad Saharanpuri. And then he taught hadith for 55 years. For 55 years he taught hadith. And from them 55 years, for 45 years he lectured on Sahih al-Bukhari. 45 years lecturing on Sahih al-Bukhari, Allahu Akbar. For him, respected brothers and elders, hadith was not an everyday job. It was not something he was paid for. For him, hadith was a full-blown passion. He used to live for hadith. Day and night he was involved in hadith. Day and night he was involved in the Quran. After teaching at Mazahirul Uloom, in his last days, because Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala caught an illness wherein a watery substance would fill into his eyes, he inevitably had to leave his lectures on hadith. And on the other hand, it was a cause for the fulfillment of his long-lived wish to say farewell to India and spend his last days in Medina Munawwara, in the mosque of the beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala, in 1974, he ordered one of his successors, one of his most prominent successors, Hazrat Mawlana Yusuf Mutala Sahib, Damat Barakatuhum, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant him a long life. He ordered him to open Darul Uloom Berri, which is named as Darul Uloom Al-Arabiya Al-Islamiya. So in 1974, Sheikh Yusuf Mutala Sahib, Damat Barakatuhum, set up this madrasa. And after this, Hazrat Zakaria rahmatullah alayh turned his full attention towards the advancement, welfare and prosperity of this madrasa. The very first financial aid had been from Sheikh Zakaria of £200 donation. £200 he donated to bury Darul Uloom to Hazrat Mawlana Yusuf Mutala Sahib, that go and start Darul Uloom Berri. On the 24th of June 1979, it was a historical day for Britain, because this was a time when Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala visited Berri Darul Uloom. And he stayed in the UK for 12 days in Berri Darul Uloom. And during this day, throngs of people from all corners of the country, they came to benefit from Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala. Approximately 2 years and 2 months after his first visit, Sheikh Zakaria made a second trip to the UK. And again, he visited the UK on the 25th of August 1981. Many of us can't even remember this time. But he visited, the second time he visited was the 25th of August 1981. And this time, because Sheikh's health had deteriorated a lot, so this time he couldn't participate in the gatherings with punctuality like he did on his previous visit. But even on this occasion, throngs of people flooded into the madrasa and special provisions were made for them. In fact, the students at the time, they emptied their bedrooms so that the visitors that had come from outside, they could stay in Darul Uloom. Allahu Akbar. The most outstanding feature of this visit of Sheikh Zakaria, this second visit of Sheikh Zakaria, was that this was the time when the first graduates of Berri Darul Uloom, after 6 years of studying, and on the final day, the final lecture of Sahih al-Bukhari was delivered by Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala on the land of UK. And this was the final lecture of hadith that has been recorded of Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala. Having spent 21 days on his second visit in the region of darkness, on the 16th of September, Sheikh Zakaria returned to Medina Munawwara where he breathed his last. And on the 24th of May 1982, Sheikh Zakaria passed away. His funeral procession was followed by a large number of people. And he was buried in Jannatul Baqi next to his teacher, Sheikh Khalil Ahmad Saharanpuri. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give Hazrat the best reward for his efforts and enlighten Hazrat's grave and grant him a high rank amongst those who are closest to him. He had sincere love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whenever he would be teaching hadith, and when the incident of the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would be delivered, Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala would not be able to contain that love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He would not be able to contain the emotions, so he would start crying. And he would cry so much that even his students, they would start crying after Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala. His personality and appearance, so Sheikh Abul Hasan Nadwi rahmatullah alayhi writes that he was of medium height, heavy set, good looking, with a fair rosy complexion, as though pomegranate seeds had burst onto both his cheeks. He was extremely vibrant, never lazy, light-hearted, smiling, cheerful, friendly, and he often gestured with his close friends and acquaintances. We saw him in good character and forbearance with people, as well as a rare humility, and above all, his personal qualities were always governed by his deep faith and sense of contentment. Many scholars, not just from India, not just from Pakistan, but even the Arabs, they paid tribute to Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah ta'ala. The great scholar from the Arab world, many of you brothers have heard the name, Sheikh Abul Fattah Ghudda rahimahullah ta'ala. He said regarding Sheikh Zakaria, the Sheikh, the Imam, the Honorable, the Jurist, the Scholar, the Noble, the fragrant flower and sweet basil of India and Hijaz, Rayhanat al-Hind wal-Hijaz. The exponent of spiritual realities, haqiqa and illusions, majaz, our leader and our blessing. Sheikh Abul Hasan Nadwi writes that upon my trip to Hijaz, I met a very honorable Arab Maliki scholar who was praising the work Awjazul Masalik. Awjazul Masalik was a commentary of Muwatta Imam Malik, a book of hadith which was compiled by Imam Malik rahimahullah ta'ala. Sheikh Zakaria wrote the commentary of this book in 18 volumes. So it's a book of Maliki fiqh. And Sheikh Zakaria is a Hanafi. And he is writing the commentary for a Maliki book. Allahu in 18 volumes. So Mawlana Sayyid Sulaiman Nadwi writes that I met this Arab Maliki scholar who was praising the work Awjazul Masalik and his author. He was saying, there is no literary work comparable to this in the works of the predecessors, the Mutaqaddimeen. Sheikh Abul Hasan Nadwi writes that the Sheikh also said that when he reports the ruling and evidences of the Maliki school in his writings, we Malikis are astonished at the accuracy and integrity of the report. If the author had not mentioned in the introduction of his book that he was a Hanafi, then I would not have known that he was a Hanafi, but have definitely concluded that he was a Maliki. Since in his Awjaz al-Masalik, he cites by laws and derives rules of the Maliki school from their books, that even we have a hard time obtaining those books. Allah. Sheikh Zakaria rahmatullah alayhi, he wrote many works in both Arabic and Urdu. I'll just go through a few of them and then move on. His written works amount to over 100. And he did not withhold any rights to his works and made it publicly known that he only published his works for the sake of Allah's pleasure. Whoever wished to publish them was permitted to, on the condition that they were left unaltered and their accuracy maintained. Hence his books have gained overwhelming acceptance throughout the world. So much so that his work, Fazail-e-Quran, the virtues of the Quran, has been translated into 11 languages. Fazail-e-Ramazan, the virtues of Ramazan, has been translated into 12 languages. Fazail-e-Salah, the virtues of prayer, has been translated into 15 languages. Sheikh Zakaria wrote 4 books on the commentary of the Quran and proper recitation, Tajweed. He wrote 44 books on hadith and its related sciences, 6 books on fiqh and its related sciences, 24 historical and biographical books, 4 books on Islamic creed, aqidah, 12 books on abstinence, zuhd, and horse softening accounts, riqaq, 3 books in Arabic grammar and logic, and 6 books on modern day groups and movements. Now coming on, this was Sheikh Zakariya rahimahullahu ta'ala, a brief explanation of the status of Sheikh Zakariya and of Sheikh Zakariya rahmatullahi alayhi, and who Sheikh Zakariya rahmatullahi alayhi was.
Ya Allah, please help me. Ya Allah, please guide me. Ya Allah, bestow your mercy upon me in this time.